So this project was the first cab off the rank with our new way of doing business. And it's been absolutely fantastic. It's taught us so much about how to engage respectfully and fully with traditional owners. As our relationship with Woppaburra has deepened, all sorts of surprising outcomes have occurred, which it's definitely not just about the science. It's about the science, its relevance to culture, and then bringing culture together with the science.
For the last 5 years in the Woppaburra Coral Project, we've undertaken over 20 different scientific experiments that have really advanced our understanding of how best to do coral seeding. And that's a restoration technique that deploys juvenile corals back to the reef. The experiments have told us about which species are best suited, which environments are best to receive those corals, and so many details about the best ways to do this method. We've developed a really strong baseline understanding of the coral communities in this region, and that's something that's so important to have so that we can understand how future events and climate change might be impacting those baselines. We've also had the opportunity to monitor how the corals have recovered from mass bleaching, and so that's really useful information to understand how resilient these reefs are. One of the great joys for me in this project has been watching Jamiga Cummins, a Woppaburra woman, really thrive and grow in her role. She started as an aquaculture trainee in the sea simulator, but she joined our team, helped develop the systems and assemble the systems for on-country spawning. It's just been wonderful to watch her thrive in her position.
Well, I know I've grown more in the sense of obligation with culture. I feel like this is the industry that I've been looking for. I've done such a great leap of progression in such a short amount of time. I feel like I will grow to some type of a level where I have much better knowledge and much better experience, and I'm in a position where I can sort of still dip into both worlds, but also source and help others come into this direction as well if they choose to approach, or if they have curious sort of interest in helping country. And how can this sort of boomerang back to my family and to the youth?
You know, when you first come over on the boat and you can see the islands, like you get this, it's almost like butterfly kind of feeling in your stomach. Stepping onto the sand for the first time in a long time, it's amazing. You can't quite put every little feeling and emotion into words. I think, hey, we know that Aboriginal people have been here for well over 60,000 years. Maybe we should start listening. So I think that's probably one of the great things about this project, right? We know as blackfellas that we know how to take care of country, but also we're only custodians here. I feel like when we're putting together science and when we're putting together traditional ways and we're kind of merging them into one, it's almost like this beautiful symphony, right? Imagine if we're able to, I guess, implement these types of practices in every other way of life. We're going to get to a point where this is our normal everyday practice. But it's incredible that Ames has been able to work with us to, I guess, be that first place that says, hey, we're actually doing this and it's actually making for great outcomes.
I think the most important and exciting part of the scientific research is looking at how corals can come back, but also how the Woppaburra people have learnt about their country and helped the Ames scientists learn about what's the best way to restore. But I think the really cool thing I saw today was with the rangers and the young Woppaburra people that have got now jobs learning about protecting country, and that's part of their employment. I think that's the most exciting thing.
When the scientists come, they reside here at the centre. When we have a school group in that might stay for a week, they'll be working with those scientists. The scientists will give the students a presentation on the Woppaburra Coral Project, and then when they're doing data collection, when they're taking tiles back or counting algae or that, the students actively get involved in that scientific work. So it's a way that the students get to see science in action in the real life.
I believe what was important, which is important in every culture, is the respect. Respect is very important, that our elders are important to us, so that they be acknowledged in every step of the process. They never miss out, which Ames has come on board with that quite well. And I think knowing their language, how they speak too, you know, like knowing all those scientific terms that they use for their coral, I'm starting to get used to that. That's what I've enjoyed as a traditional owner, is learning, is that they're learning from us and we're learning their scientific ways, you know. So it's been a good journey in these 5 years, and I'm hoping that we continue that journey.